off of Hawaii, where it still is today. Some of the information is based upon research derived from the information that I saw. For instance, in the documents that I saw, it stated that President Eisenhower had commissioned a group called the Jason Scholars, which was stated to have been a secret society of scholars, to research the deception, lies, facts, truth, and get at the root and the real truth of the alien question. It also stated that there was a group of 12 men formed by NSC Memo 5410, and that the study group was formed by NSC Memo 5411, and that there was another NSC Memo issued to cover the actions of the men claimed to be by such prominent men for meetings on a regular basis, and that NSC Memo 5412-1 and 5412-2. 5412-1 was implemented in March of 1955, 5412-2, November of 1955. Anyone who knows how correspondence and executive orders and executive memos are written knows you do not write memo 5412 in March, and then in November, back a second part on the memo was originally really written in 1954. I'm going to go through the whole history. I'm going to have to leave a few things out simply because it's going to be impossible to cover everything in an hour and a half that I have. But again, I would like to read some quotes to you. First, it's attributed to Mr. Alistair Cook, who said, quote, "I'll be astounded if this planet is still going 50 years from now. I don't think we will reach 2,000. This would be miraculous," unquote. Winston Churchill said, and I quote, "We seem to be moving, drifting, steadily against our will, against the will of every race and every people and every class, towards some hideous catastrophe. Everyone wishes to stop it, but they do not know how." What do you think, President? Ronald Reagan stated on October 18, 1983, in a meeting with Thomas Dimes, who was the executive director of the American Israel Public Affairs, and I quote Ronald Reagan, "You know, I turn back to your ancient prophets in the Old Testament and the signs foretelling Armageddon, and I find myself wondering if we're the generation that is going to see that come about. I don't know if you've noted any of those prophecies lately, but believe me, they certainly describe the times you are going to see." Ladies and gentlemen, during this talk, and I'm going to begin by going to explain to you the history of this phenomenon, who the secret government really is, and I will name my name, study group. I will tell you who they are today. I'm going to tell you what this is all about. I'm going to tell you who's selling drugs to your children. And I'm going to tell you why the United States government is afraid for you to find out what the truth is regarding UFOs. Over the early saucer recovery, but there are many more than what you expect. The early saucer is this any better? There were many more saucer fractures and down traps than what you have realized. There were many more alien bodies recovered, and there were more live aliens recovered than what you were aware of. But that's not important. The important thing is that they occurred, not how many, and not where. The important thing is that they occurred. And those of you who want to argue over how many, and where, and how many bodies, are wasting the time of everyone else. because that's not important. What's important is that they occurred. And there are two crashes that are so important that the government will go to any lengths to prevent you from finding out. And those are two crashes which occurred near the city of Aztec in Mexico. Why? Because both of those crash craft contained human bodies.